हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ अ स्मॉल ट्यूटोरियल ऑफ हाउ टू टेक जूम क्लास एज अ होस्ट। सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड विदाउट वेस्टिंग एनी टाइम। सो आई एम ओपनिंग जूम ऐप एंड यू कैन सी दैट द जूम ऐप इज़ ओपन नाउ। सो आर नेक्स्ट स्टेप इज यू कैन सी एट द बॉटम ऑफ द स्क्रीन फोर ऑप्शंस आर देयर एंड द लास्ट वन इज़ द सेटिंग्स। Go to the settings, and at the top you can see that my account is logged in, right, in a Zoom app. That means my email ID is there. We have to log out our email ID first. I'm logging out. Okay, so we have successfully logged out our account. So next step, before we sign in, right, there are some settings which we have to do beforehand. That is, you can see at the top left a setting button is there, a small icon is there. We'll click here, and the first option is meeting. You go to meetings, right? The first option, that is auto connect to audio, use internet. Okay, you have to select use internet. Next is always mute my microphone, disable, and keep it disabled. Always turn off my video, keep it disabled, because we have to, you know, turn on our video. Next is mirror my video. This will be enabled, right? Always show video preview. Yes, this also, you know, will be enabled. Next is show non-participants, non-video participants. So this is also enabled. Show name when participants join. This is also enabled. Right, auto copy invite link, this will be disabled. Closed captioning should be enabled. Use original sound should be disabled. Okay, if you enable it, you will be, you know, the our mic will catch the surrounding sounds too, so which will be disturbing our lecture. Next is show my connected time will be enabled. Safe driving mode will be enabled, and last one is reaction skin tone. Keep it by default, that is the default one. Okay, clear. So now I am coming back. So now we came to our first page of signing in page, right? Here three options are there at the bottom of the screen: join a meeting, sign up, and sign in. So we'll go to sign in. Sign in here, as you all know that we have created those Gmail accounts for this revision session only, right? So here we'll be using those Gmail accounts, right, which you teachers have created. So we'll go to Google. It's written there SSO Google feed Facebook, like which account you wanna, you know, log in to Zoom app. That will be Google Gmail account. So it is opening Gmail account. Okay, now this page is suggesting us which email account you wanna use. So we'll go to use another account. Or if use another account option or this page is not appearing, that means you have never, you know, logged into any of the Gmail account through this browser. This is the built-in browser, right? So just simply either in some of the smartphones you'll be having this suggestion page, or if it is not coming, it will come like this. I'm opening use another account option, so it will come like this. Okay, so it won't suggest you some email accounts which I've already used. So, well, suppose tomorrow we have 5th A English revision session. So here we'll be inputting our email ID, that is 5thAENG.USPC. So @gmail.com is totally optional, because as you know that this is the Gmail account, we are logging into a Gmail account. No need to give @gmail.com. It will be by default fetching. I'm pressing next. Now the password I'll be typing here that is common for all the English classes, USBC English. I press the next button. So now it is asking the Zoom should launch in few seconds. So if it is not opening, click on the below button that is launch Zoom. So I am opening it, launch Zoom. Okay, we have successfully logged in with our fifth English email ID. You can see by going to the settings, you can see there at the top, right? So now some settings before starting the meeting here too, that is go to meetings. You can see that we have already, you know, enabled or disabled some of the settings, right? This was the preliminary step which we have already done before signing in. So now coming back to meet and chat, you can see that at the bottom of the screen, meet and chat, meetings, contacts and settings. You go to meet and chat, you will be having this page. This tutorial is basically for how to take Zoom class, right, for tomorrow's session, that is or for tomorrow or for the coming days, the right, we are taking, and the meetings has already been scheduled for tomorrow's session for fifth day English. So I'm showing it to you. Meet and chat, meetings, contacts, setting, these four options are there. So we'll go to the second option, that is meetings. So meetings, as you can see that we have two scheduled meetings here. One is at 9:30 a.m. another is 10:20 a.m. right? So I'm just telling you to, and I'm starting the meeting here just to show you how it works, right? So the first one is I am pressing on the first 9:30 a.m. class fifth English online revision session, and opposite to that we have a start button. Click on the start button. Tomorrow you have to follow these steps, right? Tomorrow or for the coming days, whosoever will be having the revision session, you have to follow these steps. Okay, sorry for the video. Okay, so this meeting is started. Now you can see at the top middle of the screen the timer is coming. We have enabled the show my connected time. That means it's been 19 seconds I'm connecting to 20 21 and counting, connected to the meeting, right? I've started. So now you go to, you know, at the bottom here you have meeting options. First one is the mute. If you want to mute yourself, you will click on mute. You want to unmute yourself, you will again click on that same icon, right? Next is you want to start the video, you click on the start video. You want to stop the video, you have to click on the same icon, right? Share screen. Share screen, you want to share some presentation or some picture you want to demonstrate, or you want to use some sort of you know, some teaching aids, you can use it by share button, right? Next comes the participants. So participants are playing a very important role here, because you are shared with one Google Sheet, that is the attendance Google Sheet. So you have to go to the participants. Here the list of the students will appear, those who are joining this meeting. That means that this portion will be your attendance too, right? Attendance portion too. You have to see the name, class and section of these students, right? You can record it anywhere in the notebook or somewhere, right? You can take the screenshots too. Clear. After noting down, after completion of your, or if you have delivered your both the lectures, if you suppose you are having two lectures in a day, if you have delivered those lectures, after that just write down or fill that attendance in that attendance Google Sheet. Okay, so here at the bottom you have invite. Just ignore this, we are not using it, invite option. Next is the mute all. Mute all, I am pressing the mute all. It is asking one permission for the participant, that is allow participants to unmute themselves. We are not giving any kind of permission to the participants to unmute themselves, right? So we won't give it. So it is already ticked. That means by default it is set that allow participant to unmute themselves, but it will definitely, you know, create a chaos during your meeting, during your lecture time, because any kind of disturbance can come. So you have to see a negative aspect too. So just do not give any permission to unmute themselves. I am pressing it again to uncheck or untick, then mute all. So now all the participants are in mute mode, okay, except you, because you are the host. You will be, you know, delivering the lecture. And you can see on the screen, camera and mic sign is there. Fifth day English, that is me, means host. Okay, my video was off. I put my video in the off mode, and my you know, audio is enabled, right? Or I have already joined with the audio, right? And next is three dots. Ask all to unmute. If you wanna, you know, want that all participants should unmute themselves for some sort of query or something, but this would be the wrong idea, because according to me, or I'll suggest to you that please, if you want to, you know, have a face-to-face interaction, face-to-face conversation with the student, just give some preliminary instructions that you have to raise your hand if you have any kind of query, right? You one by one will be sorted out, okay? Do not unmute all at a simultaneously, because it will create chaos there. So you won't able to handle it, because a lot of disturbance sound will be there. So just do not unmute all at once. Unmute one by one those who are having the queries. Clear? Okay, now we are coming back with the close. At the top left we have close button. I am pressing the close. Okay, now after participants we have more option. More, in more you have disconnect audio, chat, meeting settings. So we'll go to meeting settings. I told you we before signing in we have done the meeting settings. Those were different, and this meeting is for meeting, and this is a different meeting settings. Okay, so first is the lock meeting. Do not lock the meeting until and unless the strength is not filled, right? That means if you have 20 students, let the participants participate, right? Let the students add into your meeting. After, if you got all the participants, right, or the students are logged in successfully, so after that you can lock a meeting. Otherwise it's not that you know, compulsory. Next is waiting room. This is a bit important. Waiting room, it should be enabled, right? Because you have to see one by one whosoever is coming. Waiting room is basically preventing you all from the outsiders, right? Those are unknown to us. So we are just taking precautionary measure here so that no outsider could come in our meeting session, because, right? Next is allow participants to share screen. Do not give this permission, and is already disabled, right? Next is chat with. Chat with, you have four sub options here. Allow participant to chat with no one. The first is no one, so they won't able to give any kind of message to anyone, not even to you, to the host, okay? So just select the second, that is host only, because they'll be having the query. As you know, this is a revision sessions. So just chat with host only. They will be sending the query. I have a query. Then you will tell them that we are putting you on unmute mode. Just unmute yourself, and after completing your query, just mute again. Okay. Next is rename themselves. Okay, it is enabled. Keep it enabled. We want, if any child is logged in with some different name, they could rename themselves. Okay. Next is unmute themselves. Unmute themselves, we are not giving this permission, so it is disabled. Clear? Next is meeting topic, which is already given, that is meeting title, that is class 5th A, English online revision session. Okay, play join and sound, play join and leave sound, sorry, this will be disabled. Okay, mute upon entry, this will be enabled, because we want whosoever is coming into our meeting as a participant will be in a mute mode automatically. Show non-video participants will be enabled. If you are disabling it, you won't able to see those who have not started their video. Okay, so just make sure it must be enabled too. Show name when participants join. So this should be enabled because whosoever will be joining side by side, it will be giving you a caption on your screen that this and this person has joined the meeting. This and this person has joined the meeting, right? So these were the steps, right? I am coming back again. At the top left, we have a close button. I'm coming back. So this was the session. How to take a session after that. Suppose your session is going to an end, right? So just at the end, you just give the winding up greetings to them, right? And at the right side, top right, you have end button. Click on the end button. Here you have two options. End meeting for all or leave meeting. Do not click on the leave meeting, because if you click on the leave meeting by mistake, even the access of host will be randomly go to any of the student, right? So do not click on the leave meeting. Make sure you are clicking on the end meeting for all. So it is ended now. Clear? Okay, so this was the session how to take Zoom class. I hope each and every step is clear to you, right? So all the very best for your tomorrow's sessions, right? As you will be solely taking care of Zoom classes. Okay, so wish you all the best. Have a nice day.